Hey, what's going on, everybody? Paul Tech here, and welcome to my unboxing and hands-on of the Alcatel Tetra. Now, the Alcatel Tetra is a new smartphone on AT&T's network, and this is going to be a very simple, basic, affordable smartphone. It retails for $40, so with that $40 price tag, don't expect some amazing specifications or anything like that. This is a very entry-level smartphone. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump into this unboxing. So I'm going to go ahead and lift up the top portion of the box, and lifting up the top portion of the box, as you can see, you got the Alcatel Tetra nestled right there up on top. Let me go ahead and remove it, and we'll go ahead and take a quick look at it. Now, with the Alcatel Tetra, you're not going to get that new 18:9 aspect ratio that you're seeing on some of these newer, affordable smartphones. You still got the 16:9. I'm going to go ahead and place the smartphone off to the side and go ahead and share with you what else is included in the box, just in case you are going to pick this up, you know exactly what you're getting. So first thing you do get is your Get Started Guide, as well as a safety and warranty information. Moving on from there, you're also getting your micro USB data cable, so no Type-C on the Alcatel Tetra. Moving on from there, you got your Alcatel branded wall brick. Now, with the Alcatel Tetra, you're not going to get any type of fast charging or quick turbo charging or anything like that. Just your standard wall brick is what you're getting there. Moving on from there is the removable battery. So this is going to be a 2050 milliamp hour battery. So again, not the, you know, highest capacity of a battery on a smartphone. Moving on to the Alcatel Tetra now. So as you can see, this is the device. Up on top, you do got your earpiece there. You're also getting a 2-megapixel front-facing camera, 5-inch display with Dragon Trail glass, and then to the bottom chin right there, those are your capacitive buttons. I'm going to go ahead and give you a tour around the Alcatel Tetra, starting with the right-hand side. So as you can see on the right-hand side, you got your volume rockers up on top. Then you also got a textured power button. Now moving on from there, let's go ahead and take a look at the bottom of the Tetra. And as you can see, all you got there is a microphone off to the corner. Taking a look at the left-hand side, you got no buttons whatsoever on the left hand side. Up on top, you got your charging port and a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. I'm kind of surprised Alcatel went with the charging port up on top instead of the bottom, but that is the basic layout there. And moving on to the back of the Alcatel Tetra, you are going to get your 5-megapixel rear facing camera. You got your LED flash above the camera. It appears to be like a microphone or a noise cancellation mic. And then you also got Alcatel branding to the back there, and a single backfiring speaker. And that's pretty much the design of the Alcatel Tetra. The back cover does have some pretty good grip to it. It's not going to pick up a whole lot of oils or fingerprints off your skin. And this is pretty much constructed all of plastic except for the glass display there. Now the back panel is removable, which might be a bonus for a lot of people, because you can buy spare batteries if you need to and swap the battery out. Removing the back cover also gets you access to your pre-installed SIM card, and then you also have access to inputting a micro SD card to expand the internal storage. Inputting the battery now, I'm going to go ahead and get the back cover on. Well, removable back and battery is definitely becoming a thing of the past. Going on and removing the pre-installed screen protector now, I'll go ahead and power on the Alcatel Tetra, see if we got some juice in this 2050 milliamp hour battery. And yes, we do. Alcatel powered by Android. So I'm going to go ahead and get this all set up, and I'll be back in about a second. All right, so I got the Alcatel Tetra all set up, ready to go. Up on top, you actually are getting a LED notification light on the upper right-hand corner. I'm going to go ahead and give you as much hands-on with the Alcatel Tetra as I possibly can. As you can see, you got your Google folder there with all your pre-installed Google applications. So that is what you got there. Moving on, I'll go ahead and jump into the dialer and see if we got video calling on this. So no video calling with the Alcatel Tetra. Some AT&T phones actually provide video calling within the dialer. Moving on to the messaging application now. So I always include this in my unboxings and reviews. And as you can see, you are running Gboard on the Alcatel Tetra, which is pretty nice. And those are the different emojis that you have on the keyboard there. And you even got this little option here that I know a lot of people like to send out. So you got that available. So it's good to see you got Gboard running on this. And let's see what else we got here. If you scroll to the side, you get into your Google feed there, which is pretty cool. I like having Google feed off to the corner. And then that is basically it. To get into the app drawer, just swipe up and you are into the app drawer. And these are all the pre-installed applications that comes with the Alcatel Tetra. So you are going to get plenty of AT&T bloatware, but that's pretty standard. Now the bottom buttons to the chin there, they're not backlit, so they're not going to light up or anything like that. But those are the applications that are pre-installed on the Alcatel Tetra. Now, long pressing on the display gets you into wallpapers and widgets. We'll take a look at some of these wallpapers. Now, something to consider about this display here, it is of 854 by 480 resolution. So that's 480p. Now, viewing angles aren't going to be the best on this smartphone. When you are outdoors, like I am right now, I have to have the display cranked up to 100% for best overall visibility. So, you know, this is not a very vibrant looking display. It does look kind of washed out. Pulling down the status bar there, as you can see, the different quick toggles like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, do not disturb. You got a flashlight option on this as well. And then you can also edit these. And as you can see to the bottom of the options there of hotspot, invert colors. So, you know, you do got mobile hotspot on this. And then going into settings now, I'll go ahead and show you a little bit around here as well. So network and internet. Now I did connect this to my home Wi-Fi and this only connects to 2 gigahertz. That's all you're gonna be able to connect to. So no 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi available here. Moving on from there, like I said, tethering and mobile hotspot, you definitely got that. And then let's go ahead and see what else we got here. Now you got smart manager. So as you can see, you got a power saving mode, storage, and then you also got your memory. So let's go ahead and click on storage. And this does have 16 gigabytes of internal storage, but again, remove that back cover. You can put a micro SD card to expand the storage, but 7.19 gigabytes is what is used out of the box. And then you can also see the amount of memory that you have available on the Alcatel Tetra. All right, see what else we got here. Going into display now. So you got your adaptive brightness. So you do have that available, your sleep option, and then the advanced features for the display. And then you got sound, storage, and security. Now when it comes to the Alcatel Tetra, no fingerprint sensor on this device. So your security options are swipe, pattern, pin, and password. That is what you got there. And then we'll go ahead and back up and see what else. That looks pretty much it. Going into systems now and scrolling down to about phone. And as you can see there, this is on 8.1.0 Oreo, as well as June 5th, 2018 security patch. So that is basically what you got out of the box. You got Oreo running on this. So yeah, that's pretty much it. That's what you got underneath settings. And you're also getting 2 gigs of RAM on this and a MediaTek processor, 1.1 gigahertz quad core. Moving on to the camera interface now. So I just want to share with you just for a couple minutes here, the camera interface, again, a 2 megapixel front facing camera and a 5 megapixel rear facing camera. This is the basic layout, very simple, easy to use, and shutter speed seems to be about average for a device in this price range. You got your options to the side there like timer, HDR, and flash. And you also got these other options like time-lapse, social, and light trace. And moving on from there, I'll go ahead and test out the touch to focus now. And it doesn't appear that there is an option for touch to focus or it's not working. All right, so let's go ahead and see what else we got here. So you got different filters to choose from for taking photos, and I'll back up out of there. And then I'll go ahead and do a little bit of video recording here just so you can kind of have a little bit of an idea of the type of quality. And as you can see, I'm just kind of panning around here and you have an option to pause and resume, take a photo. There's little mittens on the hunt right there. And yeah, that's basically it. So I think this camera probably does best like I am right now, outdoors, great lighting conditions, probably gonna take some nice pictures. I think in low light, it's gonna totally fall apart though. And enter settings now, as you can see, video quality is full HD, 1080p resolution. Wow, very surprised to see that, as well as video stabilization, EIS. Well, that's a basic look at the camera interface. Well, that's pretty much it for my unboxing and hands-on of the Alcatel Tetra for AT&T. Again, this is a very affordable smartphone, 40 bucks, and this is pretty much the package that you are getting. And hopefully this video does help you out if this is the device for you, or maybe you should pass up on this, go for something else. Hopefully this video does give you a little more insight into what the Alcatel Verso is bringing to the table. But yeah, that's basically it for this unboxing and hands-on. Thanks for watching. Please hit that subscribe button. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the thumbs up button and hit that bell notification so you can be notified when I upload my next video. All right, everybody, this is Paul Tech, and I will talk to you on the next one. Bye.